beginning, God made Adam, and Adam begat Seth, and Seth begat Enoch, and Enoch begat Canaan, and Canaan begat Mahalalel, and Mahalalel begat Jared, and Jared begat Enoch, and Enoch begat Methuselah, and Methuselah begat Lamech, and Lamech begat Noah, who begat Shem,
who begat Arphaxad,
who begat Sala,
who begat Eber,
who begat Peleg,
who begat Reu,
who begat Seleg, who
begat Nahor,
who begat Tilla,
who begat Abraham,
who begat Isaac,
who begat Jacob.
And Jacob begat...
Way back many centuries ago, not long after the Bible began, Jacob lived in the land of Canaan, a fine example of a family man. Jacob, Jacob and sons depended on farming to earn their keep. Jacob, Jacob and sons spend all of the days in the fields with sheep. Reuben was the eldest of the children of Israel, with Simeon and Levi the next in line. Naphtali and Issachar with Asher and Dan. Zebulun and Gad took the total to nine. Jacob, Jacob and sons, Benjamin and Judah, which leaves only one. Jacob, Jacob and sons, Joseph, Jacob's favorite son. Jacob,
Jacob,
Jacob and sons. Jacob,
Jacob,
Jacob and sons. Jacob,
Jacob,
Jacob and sons. Jacob.
Jacob and sons.
Joseph, he was Jacob's favorite son of all the family. Joseph was the special one, so Jacob bought his son a coat, a multicolored coat to wear.
Joseph's coat was elegant, the cut was fine, the tasteful style was the ultimate in good design. And this is why it caught the eye, a king will stop and stare.
And when Joseph tried it on, he knew his sheepskin days were gone. Such a dazzling coat of many colors, how he loved his coat of many colors. In a cloth above the rest, it even went well with his vest. Such a darling coat of many colors, how he loved his coat of many colors. It was red and yellow and green and brown and blue. Joseph's brothers weren't too pleased with what they saw.
We had never liked him all that much before. Now this coat has got a goat, we feel life is unfair.
And when Joseph graced the scene, his brothers turned a shade of green. His astounding clothing took the biscuit, quite the smoothest person in the district.
I looked handsome, I looked smart, you was a walking work of art. Such a dazzling coat of many colors, how I love my coat of many colors.
It was red and yellow and green and brown and scarlet and black and ochre and peach and ruby and olive and violet and fawn and lilac and gold and chocolate and mauve and and crimson and silver and rose and azure and lemon and russet and gray and purple and white and pink and orange and blue. Joseph's coat annoyed his brothers.
God, what makes us mad
are things that Joseph tells us.
The dreams he's often had.
I dreamt that in the fields one day at corn collecting time, your 11 sheaves of corn all turned and bowed to mine. My sheep was quite a sight to see, a golden sheep and tall. Yours were green and second rate, and really rather small.
This is not the kind of thing we brothers like to hear. It seems to us that Joseph and his dream should disappear.
I dreamt I saw 11 stars, the sun and moon and sky, bowing down before my star. It made me wonder why. Could it be that I was born for higher things than you? A post in someone's government, a ministry or two.
The dreams are more than crystal clear. The writing on the wall means that Joseph someday soon will rise above us all. The accuracy of the dreams we brothers do not know.
Far from home, the brothers planned the repulsive crime.
Let us grab him now, do him in while we've got the time.
This they did and made the most of it. Tore his coat and flung him in a pit.
Let us leave him here all alone, and he's bound to die.
When some Ishmaelites, a hairy crew, came riding by. The brothers changed their plan.
We can't sell him if we can.
Poor Joseph, what you gonna do? Things look bad for you. Hey, what you gonna do? Poor Joseph, what you gonna do? Things look bad for you. Hey, what you gonna do?
Could you use a slave, you hairy bunch of fish for lights? Young, strong, well behaved, going cheap for your reason right.
In a trice, the dirty deal was done. Silver coins for Jacob's favorite son. Then the Ishmaelites galloped off with a slave in tow. Home went the evil sons to break the news, let father know.
Joseph said.
They told their aging dad. Jacob wept, he really loved the lad.
Poor Jacob, you think your son is dead? Hang your weary head, hey, you think your son is dead? Poor Joseph, sold to be a slave. Situation's grave, hey, sold to be a slave. Sold to be a slave.
Thank you. Egypt's millionaires, having made a fortune buying shares in pyramids. 44 had made a huge pile, owned a large percentage of the Nile, meant that he could really live in style, and he did.
Joseph was an unimportant slave who found he liked his master, consequently worked much harder, even with devotion. Potiphar could see that Joseph was a cut above the average grade in leader of the household, maximum promotion.
Potiphar was cool and so fine, but his wife would never toe the line. It's all there in chapter 39 of Genesis. She was beautiful but evil, saw a lot of men against his will. He would have to tell her that she still was his. Joseph's looks and handsome figure had attracted her attention. Every morning she would beckon,
come and lie with me, love.
Joseph wanted to resist her, till one day she proved too eager. Joseph tried in vain, please stop, I don't believe it, please stop.
Potiphar was counting shekels in his den below the bedroom when he heard a mighty trumpet clattering above him. Suddenly he knew that riches could not buy him what he wanted, though would never make him happy if she didn't love him.
Letting out a mighty roar, Potiphar burst through the door. Done are beyond the pile.
Poor, poor Joseph, locked up in a cell. Things ain't going well, hey, locked up in a cell. Locked up in a cell. Locked up in a
every door to me, hide all the world from me, bar all my windows and shut out the light. Do what you want with me, hate me and laugh at me, darken my daytime and torture my night. If my life were important, I would ask, will I live or die? But I know the answers lie far from this world. Close every door to me, keep those I love from me. Children of Israel are never alone, for I know I shall find my own peace of mind, for I have been promised a land of my own.
If my life were important, I would ask, will I
or die. But I know the answers lie far from this world. Close every door to me, keep those I love from me. Children of Israel are never alone, for we know we shall find our own peace of mind. For we have been promised a land of our own.
Joseph's luck was really out, his spirit and his fortune low. Alone he sat, alone he thought of happy times he used to know. Hey, dreamer, don't be so upset. Walls were wet and black, his chains were heavy, weighed him down.
A candle was his only light, the hungry rat's the only sound.
Hey, dreamer, don't be so upset. Hey, Joseph, you're not beaten yet.
In the prison cell with Joseph were two very frightened men.
We don't think that we will ever see the light of day again. Hey, Joseph, help us if you can. We've had dreams that we don't understand.
Tell me of your dreams, my friends, and I will tell you what they show. Though I cannot guarantee to get it right, I'll have a go.
First the butler, trembling, took the floor. Nervously he spoke of what he saw.
There I was standing in front of the vine. I picked me some grapes and I crushed them to wine. I took them to Pharaoh, who drank from my cup. I've tried to interpret, but I had to give up.
You will soon be free, old chap, so do not worry anymore. The king will let you out of here, your bottle as you did before.
Next, the baker rose to tell his dream, hoping it would have a similar theme.
There I was standing with baskets of bread. High in the sky I saw birds overhead, who flew to the baskets and ate every slice. Give me your message, but keep it concise.
Sad to say, your dream is not the kind of dream I'd like to get. The Pharaoh has it in for you, your execution date is set. Don't rely on all I said I saw. It's just that I have not been wrong before.
Go, 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 Joseph, you know what they say. Hang on now, Joseph, you'll make it one day. Sha-la-la, Joseph, you're doing fine. You and your dream go ahead of the time. Go, 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 Joseph, you know what they say.
Oh,
hang on now, Joseph, you'll make it one day.
Yeah!
Sha-la-la, Joseph, you're doing fine. You and your dream go ahead of the time.
Thank you.
in his bed, Pharaoh had an uneasy night. He had had a dream that pinned him to his sheets with fright. No one knew the meaning of the dream. What to do, whatever could it mean? Then some lively lad said,
I know of a bloke in jail who is hot on dreams, could explain old Pharaoh's tale.
Pharaoh said,
oh, precious Joseph, man, I need him to help me if he can.
Poor, poor Pharaoh, what you gonna do? Dream go on to you, hey, what you gonna do? Poor, poor Pharaoh, what you gonna do? Dream go on to you, hey, what you gonna do?
Chained and bound, afraid alone, Joseph stood before the throne.
My service to Pharaoh has begun. Tell me your problems, mighty one.
Home and alone,
banks on the river wind,
some fat cows came on
out of the nylon.
Right behind these fine healthy animals,
conceive another cow, see the scheming and violent.
Well, anything, cause eat the fat cows, which your father would do good.
I bet it didn't make them fatter like the such a monster supper.
Well, if them bones were thin as they had ever, the hell were ever been. Well, this dream has got me baffled. Hey, Joe, won't you tell me what it means? I know that if kings ain't due, maybe I ain't got a clue. So don't be cruel, Joe.
They were gold, but you kissed it right behind them. There were seven other ears, they were tattered and torn.
Well, then the bad ones had the good ones who came up from behind them. Oh, but Joseph built the punchlines, really.
I say, Pharaoh.
Uh-huh.
What was that again?
Sit down there and I'll tell you.
But I was wandering along by the banks of the river when some fat cows came out of the Nile. Right behind me, these fine healthy animals were sitting on the cafe on the dial.
The fact was which I thought was doing good. But it didn't make him fatter.
Such a monster, such a monster.
Then one of the things he ever, ever been. This dream has got the all shook up. Treat me nice. Hey, 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 Joe.
Well, 7 years of bumper crops are on their way, years of plenty, endless wheat and tons of hay. Your farms will boom, there won't be room to store the surplus food you grow. After that, the future doesn't look so bright. Egypt's luck will change completely overnight, and famine's hand will stalk the land with food and all-time low. little king, there is no doubt what your dream is all about. All these things you saw in your pajamas are a long-range forecast for your farmers. And I'm sure it's crossed your mind what it is you have to find. Find a man to lead you through the famine with a flair for economic planning. But who this man would be, I just don't know.
Who this man would be, I just don't know.
Said,
well, stone a crow, says Joseph. He's a clever kid. Who'd have thought that 14 cows could mean the things he says they did? Joseph, you must help me further. I've found a job for you. You may lead me through this crisis, and you'll be my number two.
Pharaoh told his guards to fetch a chisel from the local store, whereupon he ordered them to cut the chains that Joseph wore. Joseph got a royal pardon and a host of splendid things, a chariot of gold, a cloak, a medal, and some signet rings. Joseph,
Joseph,
Egypt looks to you. Joseph,
Joseph,
Pharaoh's number two. Ah. Summers on the trot were perfect, just as Joseph said. Joseph saw that food was gathered ready for the years ahead. 7 years of famine followed. Egypt did not mind a bit. The first recorded rationing in history was a hit.
Joseph, how can we ever say all we want to about you? We're so glad that you came our way. We would have
Joseph, we are the perfect team. Old buddies, that's you and me. I was wise to have chosen. You'll be wise to agree.
Joseph, how can we ever say all we want to about you? We're so glad that you came our way. We would have perished without you.
We were in a jam when I baffled Abraham. But now we're a partnership, just a piece of cake.
Greatest man since Noah, only goes to show
up. Anyone from anywhere can make it if they have a lucky break.
It could be a happy ending, perfect place to stop the show. Joseph, after all, has got about as far as he could go. But I'm sure that Jacob and his other sons have crossed your mind. How had famine hit the family Joseph left behind? Back in Canaan, the future looked rough. Jacob's family were finding it tough.
What a famine has fallen on them. They are thin, they are ill, they are getting shed.
In the end, they decided to go off to Egypt to see Brother Joe. So they all lay before Joseph's feet.
Mighty prince, give us something to eat.
Joseph found it a strain not to laugh, because not a brother among them knew who he was.
I shall now take them all for a ride.
After all, they have tried fratricide, sack loads of food, and they grumbled with base gratitude. Then on scene, Joseph nipped out around the rack and planted a cup in young Benjamin's sack. When the brothers were ready to go, Joseph bound to them all with a terrible stare and said,
no! No!
No!
No!
No!
Stop!
You robbers, your little numbers up! One of you has stolen my precious golden cup!
Joseph started searching through his brother's sack. Everyone was nervous, no one could relax. Is it Reuben?
No!
Is it Simeon?
No!
Is it Levi?
No!
Is it Natalie?
No!
Is it Issachar?
No!
Is it Asher?
No!
Is it Dan?
No!
Who's the man? Is it Zebulun?
No!
Is it Gad?
No!
Is it Judah?
No!
Is it him? Could it be? 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 Could it possibly be Benjamin?
Yes, yes, yes!
Benjamin, you nasty youth.
Your crime has shocked me to the core. Never in my whole career have I encountered this before. God seize him, lock him in a cell. Throw the keys into the Nile as well.
Each of the brothers fell to his knees. Show him some mercy, Almighty One, please. He would not do this, he must have been framed. Jail us and beat us, we should be.
His brothers now were honest men. The time had come at last to reunite them all again.
Don't you recognize my face? Is it hard to see that Joseph, whom you thought was dead, your brother is me?
The world and I. drew back the curtain to see for certain what I thought I knew. Far, far away, someone was weeping, but the world was sleeping. Any dream will do. I wore my coat with golden lining, bright colors shining, wonderful and new. And in the east, the dawn was breaking, but the world was waking. Any dream will do. A crash of drums, a flash of light, my golden coat flew out of sight. The colors faded into darkness. I was left.